Hello iPod lovers! If you're watching this, chances are you've tried connecting your iPod Touch to the latest version of Apple Music, only to get hit with that frustrating notification telling you to recover your device. So, you follow the instructions, hoping for a quick fix, but instead the process stops, or worse, you're told to reconnect the iPod. Now your device is stuck in recovery mode, showing this icon on the screen. And if you've tried different iTunes versions, you've probably seen all sorts of error messages. I know how frustrating this can be, especially if this iPod holds special memories for you. But don't worry, today I'm going to walk you through to bring your iPod Touch back to life. By the end of this video, you'll have a fully working iPod ready to play music again. Before we begin, let me explain you how this video is structured. We've divided it into two parts to make it easier to follow, and you can jump to the section you need using the timeline markers. In the first part, we'll show you how to recover the iPod Touch first gen if you already have Windows XP running on a virtual machine. Once the recovery is complete, we'll also guide you through syncing music to your iPod from Windows 11. In the second part, if you don't have Windows XP set up in a virtual machine yet, don't worry, we've got you covered. We'll walk you through the entire installation process step by step. This section is marked on the timeline, so you can skip to it if needed. Alright, now let's get started with the first method. To begin, you'll need either a PC running Windows XP or a virtual machine with Windows XP pre-installed. You'll need a thumb drive containing two critical files, an older version of iTunes and the iPod firmware file for restoration. Since I can't provide direct links, you'll need to search for them on Google. You should be able to find reliable sources. Copy both files to your thumb drive, then start Windows XP in the virtual machine. Once Windows XP is running, unplug and plug the thumb drive back in. Select Connect to a virtual machine when prompted. Now, copy the two files into the Windows XP environment. Next, install iTunes on Windows XP. This version is necessary for detecting and restoring the iPod Touch first gen. Before we begin the restoration, keep in mind that this process will completely erase everything on the iPod. Any music, photos, or other data stored on the device will be lost. Once installed, connect your iPod to the PC while holding the select button. This forces the iPod into recovery mode. During the installation, always choose Connect to a virtual machine whenever prompted to ensure the iPod is properly detected. To finish the recovery, unplug and plug the iPod back in. At this point, the iPod should restart and be fully restored. Now that the recovery is complete, let's sing some music to test the iPod. One of the two iPods I recovered actually worked with the latest version of Apple Music, while the other required iTunes 12. This means you may need to test both versions to see which one properly syncs with your iPod. Close the virtual machine and open iTunes or Apple Music on Windows 10 or 11. To avoid issues, do not download the latest version of iTunes. Finally, unplug and plug the iPod back in one last time to ensure everything is recognized correctly. Your music library or selection should now sync successfully. For those setting up from scratch, this video above includes the ISO and serial key for Windows XP, and search online for the latest version of Virtual Machine. And there you have it, your iPod Touch 1st Gen is now back in action, ready to play your favorite music just like it did years ago. I want to create more videos on iPods and vintage gear, but to make this happen, I need your support. If you found this video helpful, consider subscribing to the channel and leaving a like. Thanks for watching and enjoy your recovered iPod.